Namaste. My name is Amol Gulhane and he is my friend and colleague Shubham Arora. So we are representing Robolab Technologies Pvt Ltd Pune. It is a startup which is supported and mentored by College of Engineering Pune and BHAU Institute, which is one of the premier institutes in Maharashtra and India. So to start the post-lunch session, we'd like to have a turn of the events. So we'd like to show you one of the best videos. So this video was done by our team members during last year's Ganesh festival, and it was out of a problem statement that we faced that in one of the early mornings aarti, our team missed the aarti. So the complaint was, agar aap aarti ko nahi aaoge to aarti kaun karega? So our team took it as a challenge and developed these robots and the algorithms to perform the aarti within 2 hours. So that was the fun part. So that is one of the things that our team is capable of doing. Like, we can solve any kind of problem using the technology. So instead of directly venturing into what stuff we do at Robolab Technologies, I would like to have an open interaction with all of you. So just few thought questions for the audience. So from this table, who do you think is the best batsman according to you? Batsman in cricket. Yeah. Any. Sachin Tendulkar. Who is the best tabla player according to you? Sure. Yeah. Father-son duo. Yeah. Who is the best tennis player? Roger Federer. So for three different questions, we have three best personalities. Sachin Tendulkar, Ustad Allah Rakha Khan, and Roger Federer. Now, the question is, they are using some instrument or some tool, which is available freely in the market. Sachin uses bat, Ustad Allah Rakha Khan uses tabla set, and Roger Federer uses racket. They are freely available in market. Anybody can go to market, purchase it. Would that person become Sachin Tendulkar, Ustad Allah Rakha Khan, or Roger Federer just by purchasing it? So there is a series of events that has to happen once that particular step has been done. So that is just the initial part. It requires a lot of patience, a lot of practice, a lot of hours into practice till the result is achieved. So the sad part of Indian education system is, what we expect is, once we purchase something, we want the results to be immediately and we want the best result. So let's say there are set of technologies which are available. So let's say robotics, automation, 3D printing, or even computer sets. Merely purchasing it doesn't solve the problem. So most of the institutes, what they do is they purchase the things from market or online or various shops, and they keep it in a lab and they call it center of excellence. So this is center of excellence in robotics. This is center of excellence in AI, IoT, machine learning. You name the technology, they have the center of excellence. But it is just the platform which is lying idle in the closed room, which doesn't suffice any result or anything. So what we do at Robolab Technologies, we establish this center of excellences, and then we mentor the institutes and students to take things forward. Because merely purchasing the equipment or having the physical assets at your college or premise is not essential. The students or the faculties or the end user should be empowered in such a way that they feel attracted towards those, and they can extract the maximum output from those instruments and tools. Because we are at a juncture in which we are having the technology, so much technology is available with us that every one of us is carrying a supercomputer in our pockets. In earlier days, even if we look at the Apollo mission, the first manned Apollo mission, it took off and it came back within 64 KB of memory. All the operations, rocket launching, audio visual, even the 9 photographs that they took on the moon, they came back with this, all the research and data. And this all happened in 64 KB. Right now, we all are having 16 GB, 64 GB, 128 GB of memory in our pockets. So we are at a juncture of time wherein technology can be a best tool to take us forward. And using technology, a lot of problems can be solved which were not possible by conventional methods. So technology can be a great help provided the end users, the students, the future engineers of India take it in a positive sense and try to develop solutions using those. So currently we are into domain of robotics, automation, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, and soon we'll be venturing into cyber security as well. So we started our journey, like I did my graduation in College of Engineering Pune. I graduated in 2013. But during my engineering days, though my core branch was electronics and telecommunication, me and my co-founder, we used to spend a lot of time in our robotics and automation center, which is called as Robot Study Circle. It is a center of excellence of COEP, which is kept open 24/7, 365 days. And this is literally. So even if you go at 2 a.m., you'll find 50 students working there, developing their products, developing their projects or prototypes, or even for competitions. So that kind of culture has been developed even in a government college. So even the lab keys are handed over to the students. They can come anytime. They maintain a logbook that who is having the keys and who is entering, who is going out. But the best part is the kind of culture that is being developed at COEP. It encourages the students to come there to innovate and to collaborate as well. Because learning happens via three major ways. So first is educational, another is environment, and third is the experience. So COEP, being one of the best colleges in India, provides one of the best technical resource, best technical education to the students. The kind of environment that COEP has, it is not ki COEP technical college hai to wahan pe sirf technical clubs rahenge. It has more than 60 clubs which are technical, non-technical. Even they have art clubs. So the environment which is at COEP is kind of very open culture, wherein they have very good bonding with between students and faculty members. And even the mentoring is done in a proper way, wherein the strengths and weaknesses of the individual students are identified and given necessary importance. And the most important part is the kind of experiences that the students get. In the entire 4 years of the engineering, bachelor engineering, the kind of experiences that he or she gets at COEP changes the person's mindset as well as overall personality. So through that active and indirect learning as well, a lot of things are changing in COEP and similar colleges. So when we were in COEP and we were preparing our projects, our prototypes, and also participating at various national and international level competitions, so we were winning laurels for our college, for our team members and ourselves as well. So during that time, in the final year, me and my co-founder, we got placed at other companies. But when we sat down at one of the casual meetings, we were discussing about what we would be doing when we joined the corporates and other things. So we came to realize that it would be some other job or some other task that we don't like. So we wanted to dedicate our time and efforts to the things that we like. And that was robotics and automation. So the kind of experiences and the knowledge that we gathered during our 4 year stint at COEP, we wanted to impart and share those experiences and knowledge with other students and faculties. So with that, the seed of Robolab Technologies was planted. But we wanted some solid evidence to start with. So luckily, during that time itself, we came across a survey by a big industry. So it was about how many Indian institutes are having world-class center of excellences in technology. And they named very few, like only 8 to 10 names were there, which we can easily count on our fingertips. And it was a sad part. Like India has more than 10,000 technical institutes, out of which 3,500 are engineering institutes and other universities and incubators as well. But only 8 to 10 are having center of excellences which are of world-class. On one hand, we expect very good students, very good quality projects, very good research and innovations. On the other hand, we are not providing them with the necessary platform. So again, if I come back to the first three questions that I asked the audience, would Sachin Tendulkar be Sachin Tendulkar if he was not given the bat? Would Zakir Hussain Saab be Zakir Hussain Saab if he was not provided with the tabla? Same is the case with Roger Federer. So that is the tool which is given to the individual, but the other part is tool should be assisted with the proper mentoring and coaching. Then only we can create the best performers out of them. So that is what we do at Robolab Technologies. So Robolab Technologies has recently completed 5 years of official incorporation. In those 5 years, we are majorly associated with educational institutes, industries, and defense. Currently, we are having our presence in more than 12 states, and some of the best institutes in India are associated with us, including MCEME, which is at Secunderabad. We would like to show you some of the videos and prototypes that our team has worked on. So this is a glimpse of Center of Excellence. So whenever we want to establish such Center of Excellence, first we do a site survey and get a gauge of what exactly is available at the institute premise, and then accordingly we submit a simulation video, because since we live in a technology era, we should use it actively. So simulation video gives a clear idea to us as well as the institute that how their lab is going to look like.
So this is the prototype. It is known as Flexo, the robotic hand. So it works similar to the actual human hand. See, it has some various motors and actuators, then the electronic circuit which works according to the motion of the fingers by the user. So what are the applications of such kind of things? If we install such kind of robotic hand in the satellites where there is some need to repair the satellites, so here human can act similarly on the earth. It will send the signals or process the signals to the NASA satellite, to the robotic hand, and it will do the repair kind of stuff. So it is right now a wireless thing. We'll just showing you the demo. It's a wireless thing. We can use the digital communication, the Zigbee controller. If electronics people are there, they might know about this thing. So it's a student prototype. They have created this, and we came across this thing, and we have developed this as a product. So it's not a simple thing. You can also do some innovations over that thing as well. You can take this thing as a, you can create the 3D print model of this thing. So such kind of innovations students can do over the basic things using our platform.
So interestingly, this idea was floated by one of the students in our Center of Excellence, and he wanted to develop a prototype wherein he can do something for the doctor and patient relationship. Most of the time what happens, the expert doctors are mostly situated in metro cities, but patient can be anywhere in the country. It can be in metro city or even the remotest place in India. So if in case of any medical emergency, it is the case that the patient has to travel all the way from the rural area to metro city, and a lot of time, which is very crucial, is lost in that transit. So how we can avail the best technology to bridge this gap? So currently, this particular robot can operate within a range of 1 kilometer wirelessly. Soon we'll be connecting it to internet, and then it can be operated worldwide. Now, this is one-to-one correspondence. So right now we are seeing one hand, one human hand, one robotic hand. This can be scaled at a larger level as well, and then the applications can be diverse. So with single operator, the human is the operator right now. With single operator, you can connect hundreds and thousands of such arms. And this, currently we are just imitating it. So human hand has 5 fingers, so our robot also has 5 fingers. But with technology, what we can do is, with one finger gesture, you can control hundreds of such robots, which can be put on the borders, which can be put on other areas as well, where it is required. And the application can be wherein it is hazardous for human beings to enter into. It can be atomic research centers or similar things. Therein, such robots and technology can be helpful for the mankind as well.
So, like we are also, associated with the defense people. We have automated their device, which is right now installed in this Doklam Siachen region on the Indo-China border, which is helping right now, saving many soldiers' life by searching and rescue operations. So such kind of automation we can initiate on the college level as well. So we are right now giving the training, the basic things to the students. Students can also innovate such kind of things. We are also associated with Dassault System, the 3D PLM company, Pune, with their CSR initiative. Their CSR initiative is to not to, you know, give any kind of donation to the rural people or the below poverty line people. They want to create employability in all the students. So they have developed this model, which is known as Product Innovation Lab. They have this initiative. They are establishing Product Innovation Lab across different engineering colleges. Right now, there are 6 colleges across India. 4 is in Maharashtra, 2 is in Karnataka. So such kind of, you know, Product Innovation Labs can help students to innovate. So Dassault System is also, you know, providing them the opportunity to bring some innovation in the product so that they can also help them to create a startup company. So we feel happy to share with you. We are technology partner to the company. So we are helping the students for their CSR activities.
Along with Dassault System, we are also associated with Tata Automation Limited, Genetics Pneumatics, Schmalz, and such big companies. We want to offer these great technologies to students and end users, because great technology exists in today's era. It's just, the sad part is it is not reaching to the end user. Now we are having lakhs of engineering graduates, but the technology that they learn is already outdated. So once they graduate and join any companies, the companies have to give them training afresh. So that part we want to eliminate. So the engineer who are graduating should be industry ready. They should be having diverse knowledge of all the fields, because you venture into any field right now, you need to know about IoT, artificial intelligence, machine learning. AI has entered every field. It has entered medical, it has entered finance, it has entered education as well. So in this 21st century, you need to be having knowledge of different diverse technologies which exist. So blockchain is a new entrant into that. So students should be knowing about that as well. So another interesting video that we would like to show is, this is one of our products, which is miniature industrial production system. So it is like a miniature industrial setup. In industries, there is raw material. It is passed through various filters and a set of operation is done on it. And at the output, you get the necessary products which are segregated according to types. It can be color or material. So this is a miniature industrial production system which we have established at several institutes in India. And the main motto of providing with this MIPS is, it has lot of electronics, lot of mechanical things, lot of sensors are there, lot of motors are there, even pneumatics and vacuum is present. So in one system, the end user gets to learn electronics, mechanical, pneumatics, vacuum, and PLCs as well. And they get to do the hands-on training. So they can stop it, they can run it, they can change the code, they can change the hardware, they can change the mechanism, and see what is happening in real time. So these are different discs of different material and different color. Those are placed at random initially, and then they are passed through a series of operation wherein they get sorted according to their color and material.
So it's kind of a small scale of a big, you know, industrial assembling station. So such kind of, you know, educational platforms can, you know, help students to get a good job in a bigger companies in their future.
And the trainings that we deliver at institutes or incubators or industry does not just make them employee ready. It also empowers them to be an active learner. So irrespective of whether they want to be a job seeker or job creator, one must be active learner. It can be management, it can be technology, or it can be finance as well, because these things keep on changing. And unless you learn actively from different sources, it can be internet, books, or even the mentors. So that thing has to be there. So We have provided multiple trainings at different institutes in India, and we are very happy to share that we have had other startups which are coming out of institutes, other students who are doing their own ventures, who are developing their own prototypes and selling it. So the startup culture has been evolving again and again. I'd like to show you one of the actual site location that we have developed along with the digital version of it. On left top you can see a digital version which was a simulation video, and right bottom you can see the actual site, which is at MVJCE College of Engineering, Bangalore.
It's like before creating the lab actual, we'll share this video with the college. So if they, you know, wants to customize any other thing specifically, so we'll do that thing. So like without spending a single penny, a customer can see whatever the product we are delivering to them. And that is what I guess industry is also, you know, focusing on, this industry 4.0, that we need to create some simulated products first. Then we'll check in the simulated environment, the virtual environment. Then we will see whether it is feasible for us to, you know, manufacture a single prototype in the market or not.
So, currently,
that is a kind of, you know, digital twinning thing, the concept, digital twinning.
So, out of the domains that we are interacting with right now, in educational domain, we are associated with schools, diploma colleges, science colleges and engineering colleges. Also incubators and universities. For industries, we are associated with software as well as manufacturing industries. And for defense, we are also providing technical expertise for various problem statements that they offer and the solutions that they require. So it can be helibone operation, or it can be surveillance, or it can be some mundane tasks that they want it to be automated. So with our venture, what we want to do is we want to take the technologies to masses. And the technology is robotics, automation, artificial intelligence, and IoT. So with this, we would like to conclude. In case there are any questions, feel free to ask. Thank you.